Hey guys, my name is Priscilla Elias, and today we will talk about dodge and burn, a technique that is very much used when editing to give more emphasis to the areas of the photos you think are more important, to make these specific areas pop and make your photo reach another level. Dodging increases the exposure of the areas of the photos you wish to be lighter, while burning decreases the exposure of the areas of the print that you believe should look darker. I usually do this in Photoshop, but you can use both Lightroom or Photoshop, and I will teach you how to use the dodge and burn tools in both softwares, so you have the option to work with whichever suits you best. So let's do this. So I'll come to the develop mode in Lightroom. You'll come to this icon right here on the right, come to brush, then you'll come here on effect, and you can set anything here, or you can even use the custom button. I have some effects from Brixton I like to use. So for example, I have here dodge plus. And what it does is it simply changes the exposure. So either way, if you don't have this, it's okay. You can just come here to custom, or you can come to exposure, and then you just increase it a bit, like 20, 30. Let's start with 20, and then you can start working on your image. So I'll start making the areas of the photo I want to be brighter, brighter. This is too little, so let's increase this. There it goes. Now, from the start, I'll tell you, I prefer to work with this in Photoshop, and you'll see why in a minute. But in case you only work with Lightroom and you prefer to work with Lightroom, it's all right too. So I'm first working on the highlights, making everything I want to look brighter to look brighter. I guess that's good to me. And now we'll get a new exposure brush. Now we'll set the exposure down so we can highlight the shadows, or we can increase the shadows. Just like that, increase the shadows. Make this makeup pop. Too much. This is why I don't like to work with Lightroom as much as I'd like to work with Photoshop with this, because I feel I have more control with Photoshop. I'll get a third brush, also for the burn tool, but this time I won't make it so hard. So I'll have one brush that's harder and one brush that's lighter. Let's see around here. So let's see before and after. Big difference already, huh? If you do this in Photoshop, I'll just reset everything here. Bring this to Photoshop. So edit in Photoshop. Okay, here we are. So here I can see my layers. I will duplicate my layer by hitting Command J. That way it doesn't matter how many changes I do to this image. If I want to get back to zero, I can just delete this and it's done. So whatever changes I do in this photo will happen to this second layer I create here, which I will name Dodge and Burn. And then I'll click this icon right here. I'll come to dodge. And this is why I like Photoshop for this better. I can change the exact range I want from the photo. So for example, if I want to make the shadows lighter, I can use the dodge only on the shadows, or on the midtones, or in the highlights. So for instance, let's start with the midtones, because I'm mostly using the dodge tool here on the areas of the skin. They can work with the highlights too, but they work with the midtones also. So I'll set the exposure here for around It really depends, but usually around 15 to 30. And the second good thing I really like to work with these tools in Photoshop is because if I click here once, it gets a certain amount of brightness. If I do it again, it's brighter and it's brighter and it's brighter. And that is not as easy to do in Lightroom. Sometimes I need to create two different new masks to do a burn or a dodge tool. So I think this is much easier in Photoshop. Maybe it's just because I'm used to it. This is a photo from a photo shoot I took last year before I got pregnant. So here I'm working on the mid-tones. I want to make my hair pop. I want to make it look like it has more highlights and shadows. Maybe a little bit brighter here and here. Let's see the before and after, okay. Now we'll go to the same icon right here, the right burn tool, and we'll do the same thing with the shadows. So I also want the mid-tones. Let's start with this. And if I need to set the range to highlights or shadows, I can do that also. But right now, I want these areas that are in the mid-range, so I want them to get darker. Here's some dark areas in the hair. Let's make this makeup pop a bit also. Change this to shadows, so I'll change exactly what I want here. So looks good. And if you make any mistakes, you can just hit Ctrl or Command Z and redo whatever you're doing. So yep, I guess that's pretty much it. Let's see, so before and after. Burn tool to the background. So shadows, exposure, maybe 20%. Let's increase the size of the brush. And for you to access the menu of the size of the brush, you just hit the right button on your mouse when you're working on the image and just adjust it. I guess that's it. Let's see. Before and after. That's it! That's how you use the dodge and burn tools to improve your editing and make your photo look even better than it did originally. I use this technique in pretty much every photo I post to my social media accounts and YouTube videos simply because I think it makes the whole difference in terms of results. It gives the photos that special final touch that only a detailed editing will do. I love it and I totally recommend you try it too. That is all for today, guys. I hope this video helped you to understand what the dodge and burn tool is and how to use them. I hope it helps you to improve your editing. Please let me know if it did, please let me know if it didn't. If it did, please hit the like button and subscribe to this channel as you will help me a whole lot in return so that I can keep creating more and more content like this one. Thank you so much for watching me and I will see you in the next video. Ciao!